In this blog, we will try to see how to create a bottom sheet using GetX library. So in our previous tutorials, we have seen how to create a snack bar and also a default dialog using GetX library. If you have missed those tutorials, I am providing the link in the description section below. You may go through them. So here the first requirement is like you need to add the get to our dependencies here. So this is the version available like 4.1.4 currently. So after adding the dependency, you need to tap on the pub get so that our dependency will be loaded into our project here. Under the external libraries, you can have a look. So here you can see under the external libraries, we have our get dependency for the version 4.1.4. So just make sure that you have successfully added the dependency. So here now let's get started with our coding. So now let's start with importing material.dart, and also we need to import get.dart here. So these two are the imports, and now let us declare void main and in run app. Let us specify the default class myApp here. So now we will be considering a stateless widget myApp. So yes. And now instead of container, we will be returning a get material app. So if you want to know why do we return a get material app, I suggest you to go through our previous tutorials on GetX library. So there I have clearly explained why we are making use of the get material app here. So inside the get material app, we will be having the same option like home here, which we were having for material app, and for which we will be declaring a scaffold. So using scaffold, we will be providing the skeleton for our application. So we are specifying an app bar. So these are all the general things we follow for application development. So I'm just specifying these things for the beginners. Inside the body, I'm just considering a column now so that we may have multiple children according to the requirement. So here inside the children, for now I'm specifying a text button, and for which we have these two default parameters on press. And for child, I'm specifying a text widget, and for the child we can specify a text widget, and here we can specify a bottom sheet. So yes, now within the text button, we will now try to load the bottom sheet when the user tap on this button. So get dot, you can just start typing bottom sheet, and here you can get the option here, bottom sheet. We need to specify the parameters for our bottom sheet. You might get confused if you are trying this for the first time, like what we need to specify, and you can just go through the documentation here. So it's clearly specified what we need to provide. So the first parameter is a widget here. So don't get confused what we need to provide here. Just consider a container or whatever the widget you require here. But I am providing a container, and you can see all our errors are gone. So now let us just, as you provide your widgets inside the container, likewise just provide the widgets here what you require to be represented in your bottom sheet. So first of all, to display our bottom sheet, I just want to make with a color. So I want to provide some color here, colors.white10. So yes, just to make the structure of our bottom sheet. And now let us try to run this on our device. So here you can see we got the button to the top left here, and when you tap on it, you can see a bottom sheet is raising up here, and we have specified a white10 here, you can see. So if you have specified white, and now let us try. So here you can clearly see now So this is our bottom sheet, and now we will try to customize it a bit. So let's see what are the parameters we are having. So this is the easiest way of using any widget in Flutter. As a Flutter is an open source, you can just go through the documentation here, and also you can create your own widget using this code available here. So now I just want to add some elevation here, so that whenever the bottom sheet is up, it will be somewhat elevated. So outside the container, you need to provide elevation. So I just want a 20. So just for the example, so here you can see now the elevation. And also I just want my bottom sheet to have rounded corners. So is there any option for this? Yeah, we are having a shape here. So now let's try with this shape, and here let's consider rounded rectangular border inside which border radius. And so I just want the radius on the top, so I'm just specifying border radius dot only here, and inside which I will be providing top left and top right, leaving the bottom left and bottom right. Radius dot circular, and I just want a 10 for top left and the same for top right here. So now let's have a look. So to have a clear look of the radius, we need to remove the container color here, and I will be providing the background color instead. So let's take white 10, and here you can see our radius. Take white. Now save the code, and here you can clearly see now we have got top left and top right here. So this is our exact bottom sheet which we require, and inside the container you can specify what are all the things you require. So now let us try some more parameters before getting into the content. So is dismissible. So whenever you are trying to open the bottom sheet, and when you try to tap anywhere else, it is getting dismissed, right? So now let's make it disable. Is dismissible. So let's provide it false, and now try here. So now we cannot dismiss the bottom sheet anywhere else when you tap anywhere else on the screen. So you can just provide a close button here, or whenever you select any option, you can make it as automatically close. And what are all the other options we are having? Enable drag here. So we will be seeing these things when we add some content here. Let's provide the child here, and for which we can make a column, and inside the children I will specify a list tile here, and inside which let's specify a title. So this like an option one. Okay, so these are all the options you can specify. Let's make it a single line so that we can add multiple list tiles here. So not only list tile, you can also add a text widget. But if you add a list tile here, so why I have added a list tile here is like you can just specify an icon here. So you can provide any icon here. So let's provide the alarm icon, and now let's try to reload the screen here. So now let's see here, we have got an icon and text as well. So let's provide some padding, and also let's remove this dismissible option so that it will allow us to close our bottom sheet. And now just we can freely open and close the bottom sheet. And so this is our first option. And also now let us try some more. And now here you can observe we are able to drag the bottom sheet And we can also disable this functionality here. So enable drag if you make it false here. So now let us try to see, and we can't drag the bottom sheet anymore. So this is the duration, like enter bottom sheet and exit bottom sheet. So you can just try it with any animations. And this is a clip behavior barrier color here. Let's try this barrier color. So colors dot, let's specify blue color. So just I'm seeing how this will look. So here you can see the top area is being covered with the blue color. Generally, let's make use of white and let's provide some transparency here. And now let's try to load. So in this way, you can just make use of the available parameters. So it looks good, right? But you can just change the color of the bottom sheet so that it looks much more efficient way. And what are all the other options? So mostly we have seen. So this root navigator and ignore safe area, I think, you know, these are all the basic things we have covered regarding a bottom sheet when we try to use it with the help of a GetX library. So yes, this is it for this tutorial, and I hope you understood how we can use a bottom sheet using GetX library in Flutter applications. So the course for this tutorial is available in the description section below. And if you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.